Hey, I'm Becky Stern, and I've been making electronics projects for over 15 years. And today I want to share the advice I wish I could go back and give to beginner me. If you're just getting into DIY electronics, or even if you've been at it for a while, these tips might save you some time and energy. This video is sponsored by DigiKey, a distributor of parts and tools for your own projects. And they host my introductory electronics teaching video series on their YouTube channel, which elaborates on many of the tips you're about to hear. I'll put a link in the description. And thanks to DigiKey for their continued support of my channel too. Let's start with tools. Buying fancy tools doesn't replace practice, but sometimes, yeah, the fancy version is genuinely better. Soldering irons and wire strippers in particular. Spending a bit more here can really make your experience smoother. A good soldering iron heats faster, holds temperature, and doesn't make you feel like you're fighting the tool. But the tip must be clean to work well. Even the best soldering iron won't work well if the tip is dirty. Soldering iron tips come in different sizes. Use a fine tip for small joints and a bigger chisel tip for beefy power connectors. And cheapo wire strippers lose their edge quickly, making them frustrating to use. You don't need this big complicated automatic one, although it is nice. A set of Hakko wire strippers will last you years. I asked on social media what y'all wish you knew, and Sam Freeman says he wish he knew there were more than one type of solder. Mainly there are two types, leaded and lead-free, and they don't stick to each other very well. Good tip, Sam. You don't have to memorize the resistor color code chart. Seriously. Just look it up when you need it. Or cross-stitch a chart and hang it in your workshop if that's your vibe. I've got a pattern for that. But do try to remember the most common values like 1K and 10K. They'll come up again and again. And if you're having trouble telling the difference between brown, black, red and brown, black, orange, you may need to improve your workspace lighting. Being good at electronics doesn't mean knowing everything. It means knowing how to troubleshoot. It takes practice and a lot of multimeter probing before potential problems will jump out at you. And if something's getting too hot to touch, that's a red flag. You might have a short circuit, so power off and check continuity with your multimeter. Most of your project time will be spent fixing something small. Progress won't look like a straight line, and that's okay. You don't know the true meaning of patience until you've worked out your first circuit issue. The magic combo is trial, error, and documentation. Take photos, write notes. Help your future self with the inevitable question, why doesn't this work now when it worked earlier? Parts can go bad, even jumper wires and solderless breadboards. If something's weird, don't assume the parts are perfect. Test them with a multimeter, or swap them out one at a time. And if your Arduino sketch isn't working, sprinkle in serial.println like it's seasoning. Your project will start talking back, giving you clues as to what's happening when. Wires are colorblind, but you're probably not. Follow color conventions. It's not just for aesthetics, it's your sanity. Solderless breadboards are great for prototyping, but they won't hold up inside a project. If you want something to last, make a perf board version. Or a PCB. I have videos about both of these processes in my DigiKey series. And always read the documentation thoroughly. Data sheets, pinouts, tutorials. You don't need to know everything, just how to look it up. Start with what you want to build and learn as you go. And hey, making something janky that works is better than nothing at all. Don't let perfectionism stop you. And finally, it's not done until you photograph it. Share your builds. You'll connect with a community of curious, generous, creative folks just like you. If you found any of these tips helpful, please give this video a big thumbs up, subscribe down below, and catch up on my past projects by signing up for my email newsletter. See you next time. This video was made with support from my sponsors and generous donations from viewers like you through Patreon and YouTube memberships.